Hello and greetings from Iceland. This update is dedicated to the latest news about the land uplift, the homeless people from Grindavík and the tourism industry that has also suffered a bit due to all this. And I'm of course using the chance to spice up the video with some new footage. And starting the update with this new interview with Professor Þorvaldur Þórðarson, he has always something interesting to say. Like this time he was saying that if you look at this drop that occurred in Svartseng on November 10th, 2/3 of it is below the zero point that existed before Svartseng started to rise. So he wonders if this has more to do with tectonics than previously believed, and it would not be a surprise. These events have been examined more on the basis of volcanology so far, but that might be changing. And this made me also wonder about the geothermal power plant, because since 1976 when it opened and until 1999, the land dropped by 24 centimeters due to the exploitation of geothermal fluids, and the affected area was estimated to be around 100 square kilometers around the power plant. So it is clear that the power plant alone has been changing the land there. And a total of 9.45 million tons were injected into the geothermal reservoir between 1984 and 1990. But it would be nice to see the total numbers or how much the land has sunk due to the power plant and how large area around the power plant has been dropping. And is the power plant a part of the story in some way? What scientists do however seem to know is that there is still magma inflow into the sill by the power plant, but no flow from the sill to the dike. And the system is not fully back to square one or overpressurized like before November 10th, or when the magma took off to form the dike that stretched under the town. But the land has however risen by 30 centimeters already, so we are almost there. But the town remains closed and still categorized as a danger zone. And the official explanation now is that an eruption could start within 2 hours after the earthquakes start again, which isn't very encouraging, I must say. And the most likely location for an eruption according to a new risk assessment seems to be the Blue Lagoon and the power plant, or where the land uplift epicenter is. And the probability of an eruption from the dike is considered insignificant right now. However, another magma run from the sill to the dike has to be just as likely now as it was before November 10th. And another such event would open up a whole new and unpredictable scenario. But there are more hidden connections there that I would like to know more about. Like, I'm curious to know about this connection between the mountain Þorbjörn and Faradalsfjall. But the first eruption in 2021, it started after a magma intrusion by Þorbjörn, like we are having now. And the seismic activity then migrated to Faradalsfjall, where 3 eruptions would then occur, the last one in July. And I would like to know what scientists say about this connection, so feel free to use the comment section as always. And I'm saying this now because I noticed a little uptick in seismic activity under Faradalsfjall, and my wishful thinking was asking for the eruption to occur there or to get this over and done with. But Professor Þorvaldur Þórðarson, he expects this to fade out now, and he actually tends to get his long shots right, although some of them can be categorized as an educated guess rather than scientific assumption, and those experts who dare to try to make the long shots, I like them more. The others who never dare to say anything, they are quite useless for a channel, to be honest. But we do, however, still have those earthquakes in the dike, like we see daily on the seismometers, and one might ask if it's normal, and yes it is, they could go on for months, like we witnessed after the so-called Holuhraun eruption in 2014 that emerged from a dike that stretched over 40 kilometers underground. So those dikes can keep on shaking for even years, or after the eruption comes to an end. But as for my own guess, or the uneducated guess about the future, I decided to be sensible and wait for a few days until the land uplift is more than before the November 10th event. I think it's only then when we can make a better guess about what is to come. Although there are experts out there saying that we have reached the point of no return. And that sounds convincing, actually. Unless this is more of a tectonic event than we previously believed. Or that's what I think from listening to different voices. And I have to mention those earthquakes that we have been having on the Mid-Atlantic Ridge today. They are already in the comment section. Many of them are far away, but we got one, magnitude 4, this afternoon. And I've actually seen this trend that offshore earthquakes, they tend to mean that we might get some action on the peninsula. It might be a coincidence, but anyone can look this up online. And since things are how they are and this discussion is now open about the tectonics, I'm curious to see how the next days will turn out. And overall, I think it's very hard for the science community to read this event and explain it fully. And this might even get more complicated for them. But at least this will be a good school. And it's not just scientists. The people of Grindavík is also waiting for answers. And around 380 of them, including 100 children, have not got apartments yet, according to the latest information. They are living with relatives and such. And right now we have this effort going on to get everyone into apartments before Christmas. And I'm actually optimistic that it will work out, although the rental market here is not good. The government will support this effort with grants, but when people can return is still the big question that no one can answer. And I'm ending this today with tourism, since we can see a clear short-term effect in airline bookings. And a lot of it has to do with the Blue Lagoon closing. And many Icelanders think it's a lame excuse to cancel a trip because the Blue Lagoon is not a natural bathing place. But the trademark Blue Lagoon is extremely strong and they've done a lot for Iceland when it comes to promoting the country. And it is a kind of waste when people are cancelling trips for all the wrong reasons. Like some of those who are cancelling are doing it because they are scared. But there is, however, nothing going on here that threatens the safety of tourists. And since I'm talking about tourism, I want to make it clear that my videos are not sponsored by anyone but my viewers. That means that I'm free to tell you what towns are miserable or not, or the information you won't get anywhere else. And this is a sample from a long Christmas mood video I'm making now. It's going to be a long one with the Arctic Sun and even Santa Claus. And the travel tip of the day is that EasyJet is now flying straight to Akureyri from London Gatwick. Or to this international airport just by the Arctic Circle, where we can easily get something like this. And we even have some trees here in the north, the whole package. And there are no volcanoes nearby, if that is what people are avoiding, or the people who think that the snow is cooler than the volcanoes. So don't cancel your trip to Iceland for the wrong reason, is my message now. And if you want winter wonderland, you come straight to North Iceland. And finally, I just uploaded an inspiring video about this lava spire and I'm linking to it. And it's plenty more to come in December. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.